Amen. Yeah, my son said if he got in trouble, usually my wife and I would discuss it together. Then I would use the belt. I have to give it to them, and I don't want to boast or brag, but they were pretty good kids. Didn't have a whole lot of trouble out of them. Just thank God for that. If you got some good kids, you need to be proud of them. You need to let them know. Tell them about the good things and stay off the negative, because it does have an impact on them. And I just appreciate it. I just got my hair that color because of my age, not because that they worried me or anything. So just appreciate it. And again, we'd like to say we appreciate your response on today, and hope, trust, and pray that we'll be able to say some encouraging words again that will get your attention to be focused on what God will have us to do. And that's the whole key, is doing the things that would be pleasing, acceptable to God. Not to the elders, not to the preachers, not to the deacons, but to ourselves. And we have an obligation to ourselves to do what God will have us to do. And we again like to say, we want to give your lives to God. That's a sacrifice. That's an ultimate sacrifice, is that we want to put our hands in God's hand. Not in Allstate, not in State Farm, not in the Geico commercial, but in God's hand. And when we put it in God's hand, God will deal with us justly. And it's wonderful how God deals with us justly. And sometimes we have a problem with dealing with others justly. But we want to be more like God. We want to be just like God. We want to get the image of Jesus Christ. Can you remember when the Lord came on this dusty earth? And he told them that he was going to tear down that place and build it in 3 days. Well, they didn't quite understand it, because they said it took 40 years to build that place. And how in the world is he going to tear it down in 3 days and have it built? But these are the things that we have to look at, that God has plans for us, church. And when he has plans for us, we need to fit in the mold and be in that plan. Now, don't y'all worry, I'm not going to really be long tonight. I found the secret in preaching. If you preach a short, significant lesson that someone can comprehend what is being said, then I can live a little longer. There's no need of me staying up here all night trying to tell y'all what to do, and most of y'all going to do like you want to do, but as long as you do what God wants you to do. This is why we need to give our lives to God. So, brothers and sisters, since God has shown us great mercy, and I want you to understand, he says, now I beseech, he says, I beg you, offer your lives a living sacrifice to him. Your offering must be only for God and pleasing to him, which is a spiritual way for you to worship. Do not change yourselves to be like the people of this world. You know, the people of this world is very cruel. You know, when you have a job, when you go on your job, if they say you're supposed to be there at 7, not 7:01, not 7:05, and especially not 7:20. Well, now, if you do that, you are in violating of their orders, and you are violating God's order, because you're supposed to be able to be one that people can look at you in this world and say that you are a different individual. And that's where the proof comes about. So in the Lord's house, we need to show and be disciplined as well. When you get out there on the road, you got speed limits to obey. We're supposed to be obeying the laws of the land. We're supposed to drive a certain way. We're not supposed to be using Wilson Boulevard as a Daytona 500 speed. We're not supposed to be using ourselves to break the laws of the land. When we get to a stop sign, we should stop completely. See, we got a yellow sign, which just say yield. Well, you can yield at that when you don't have to stop completely. But when you have a stop sign, we have to learn what has to take place. 2 Timothy 2:15, the Bible said, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, that you may rightly divide the word of truth. So we as individuals, when you go home tonight, or when you get up in the morning, we ought to be so thankful. You know, I used to jump up out of the bed, now I just roll out of it. And that way I'm closer to getting on my knees. Thanking God for allowing me the opportunity to have a restful sleep on the night. To get up in the morning and thank Him for seeing another day. See, we got to stop taking for granted that these things is just going to happen to us. They don't just automatically happen. I was leaving here today and I told my wife, I said, we need to go to St. Vincent before we go home. So we went to St. Vincent, and I went to the ICU room to see a fellow brethren that's in the hospital. And I was told on last night that they wasn't giving him much time. And so when I went in, the nurse, you know, they have the rules and regulations at the hospital. So you don't just go in there and do whatever you want. She told me to put the mask on, put the gloves on, then I went in to see the individual. When I got in, I told him who I was. He said, he had a smile. I say, now, let's make sure we get things in order right now. Let's talk to God. Let's make sure that you have things in order. That we see, somebody over there get Psalms 139 and 16, and I'll be there in a minute. And I told the individual, I say, God loves you. But see, we must understand that we're not going to be here forever. And I sure thank God we're not going to be here forever. Don't you know it's got to be somewhere better than this place? Has to be. If it wasn't somewhere better than this place, we wouldn't be working so hard to make heaven our home. Anybody don't want to go to heaven, there's got to be something wrong with them. You know, I never like heat much. Gets too hot. I don't really like it when it's too cold. Gets too cold. But I love it when the temperature is just right. And when you get around God and you go to His place, everything will be all right. I'm not preaching a funeral here today, but I'm just getting us ready because that grand day is coming. We serve the Lord to get better things. Now the Bible says in Psalms 139 and 16,
thine eyes did see my substance.
Okay, what that?
Yet being unperfect.
Okay.
And in thy books all my members were written, which in continuance were fashioned. Uh-huh. And as yet there was none of them.
Okay, now, that's Psalms 139, 16?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what I wanted to get out of here is that, first of all, God has our days allotted for us. Mm-hmm. None of us can rush them. None of us can extend them. because from our birth, they were alive. Ms. Reagan was 90-something today. 94 years old. That was her allotted time. And I know a lot of us like to live till we get 94, 96, 98, 100. But you better thank God and hope and trust and pray that your children don't mind taking 10. But when we think about giving God, giving your lives to God, there's some things that we must look at. When we think about it, then you will be able to decide what God wants for you. You will know what is good and pleasing to Him and what is perfect. You know, a lot of people don't like to use perfect, but I love to use perfect because all it means is that you are complete. Because God has given me a special gift. I have something to say to every one of us among you. Do not think you are better than you are. You must decide that you really are by the amount of faith that God has given you. Each one of us has a body with many parts, and these parts have all different uses. In the same way, we are many, but in Christ, we are all one body. Each one of us has a part of that body. Each part belongs to the other part. We all have different gifts. Each of us has a gift in the agreement with the faith that we have in God. Some of us have a gift of teaching. Good teachers. But some of us don't like to use our talent. Whosoever have the gift of encouraging others should encourage others. Whosoever have the gift of others to give freely to others. Anyone that has the gifts of being a leader should try hard when he leads. Whoever has the gift of showing mercy to others should do so with joy. You have a special gift. This is why on last night when we was leaving the singing, the lady asked me, she said, please go by and see him. Put him on the list. And that is why. That is my main ministry in my work there, is visiting the sick, visiting the delinquents, those who are not so faithful in the Lord's church. We have to encourage them. We have to work with them. You know, sometimes some of us wasn't as faithful as we should have been. Some of us let other things get in our way. But we have to move the obstacles out of our way so we can give ourselves to God. And when we move ourselves out of the way, we become obedient to God to serve Him and allow nothing to get in our way. Are we obedient enough to serve God? Are we following Him? Are we getting sidetracked for not serving Him? So this is why and what we need to do to be a living sacrifice. By the mercies of God, God has accomplished for us as Christians to live a godly life, encouraging others, admonishing one another, helping those that are in need, lifting those up that have fainted and fallen by the wayside. If we know that there's someone, Brother Crosby made a profound statement, this should be the responsibility of us all. When we see someone that's not here, we should be calling them, encouraging them, admonishing them, just be jubilant. Do you know when you encourage someone, it encourages you. It helps you. Because the Lord says that when you do these things to someone else, you are considering doing them to yourself. And I like to say to each and every one, let us encourage someone. Let us teach someone and put them on the right track so we can show our love one to another. That's why the Bible says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. I don't want you in the Lord's church fussing and fighting. And be not conformed to this world. This world is not our home. Are you planning to stay here? Got to be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Let us picture that like we're looking at Mona Lisa. In other words, let us picture that as we look at Jesus hanging on the cross of Calvary. Came to this old dusty world. Died the cruel death of the cross. Died for you and for me. Died so we can have a right to eternal life. You know, I know, and you probably know, that when we out there in the world and we thought that we was praying to God, but if we wasn't serving him, we hadn't obeyed him, we had no need to call on him. You're going to call on somebody that you don't put your trust in. That's a terrible thing to do. You say you love God, act like it. Show yourself how you love it. Put on the whole armor of God. Be ready for the battles. Sometimes when the things get tough, we got to get tough by going to God. I don't care how bad someone may treat you in this daily walk. Don't worry about what they do to you. You know, we used to say when we were kids, you can say anything you want to, just don't put your hand on me. Whatever you want to say, just don't bother with me. You know, I got that feisty from my mother. My mother didn't take no stuff. She didn't take anything. But what I'm saying, church, people will try to discourage us. People will try to misuse us. But we are to give our lives to God and praise him for everything that he does for us. And in my conclusion, we want to thank God for allowing us to be a member of his church. We want to praise God for thinking about adding us to his church. This is the best institution that we could ever be in. Lord, we thank him for allowing us. I know when I got out of high school, I married my wife, then I went to the war. I didn't ever shoot a gun till I went through training at Fort Benning, United States Army, the largest army base in the United States. Went there, trained, got sent to Fort Pope, Louisiana, never been down there much. Trained to be a clerical person. Didn't have a clue about what I was going to do. And they gave me 15 days leave time. Oh boy, and I just couldn't hardly leave my wife. Couldn't leave her. And I stayed too long. Yes, I did. I'm just telling you like it is. That 15
article, on Article 15. I ain't getting about that. I love my wife. I ain't leave her for a year.
Yes. But you know, an 80-year-old lady used to sit over there and that lived in front of my wife, and she said, "Son, you're going over there, and you're not going to even get a scratch on you." Well, I tell you, I love to listen to old folks. I'm getting to be old now. Old folks know what they're talking about. You can act like you turn up your nose if you want to. But them old folks, they know what they're talking about because they've been around here a long time. And I respect them. And man, I tell you, she was right. Because when I went over there and I had to pull guard duty twice and had to get in a foxhole and didn't even have any bullets in the gun. So I told them, I said, "I'm not coming up out this foxhole. I'm going to stay down in here, and all y'all going to have to do is cover me up if somebody shoots me. I'm not coming out." And I didn't come out. But I tell you what, the Lord took care of me. Here it is, some 40 years later, and I thank God for it. And like I say, when the young lady told us about the church and we obeyed the gospel of Jesus Christ, that's all it took. We thank God for it. If you're here tonight, have not obeyed the gospel of Jesus Christ, you have that opportunity to hear the word, believe the same. Repent of your sins, confess that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Go down in a watery grave of baptism for the remission of sin. And that water and that blood that you won't see will cleanse you from your unrighteousness. Live a faithful, dedicated Christian life, and God will give you a crown of life that won't ever fade away. And in that crown of life and in that walk for God, keep your eyes on the cross. Because people in the Lord's church and outside the church, on your job, they will try to deter you, try to make you deviate from what you're supposed to be doing. But stay on course. And live the life that Christ has promised unto us. Being faithful unto death. And God will give you that crown that won't ever fade away. If you're here and you're already a member of the Lord's church, and you know that you just hadn't been doing as much as you should have been doing, you have the opportunity to get it right with God. You have the opportunity to say, "Lord, I'm ashamed of the way that I live in your church. I've lived like filthy rags, not even worthy to be called your child." But you see, God doesn't deal with us like that. We can be just as ugly with an attitude. We can just be as ugly and mean to one another. But God forgives us. That's why we have to give our life to Christ. And he forgives those who mistreat us. Because long as you walk in this journey following Christ, the devil is always going to get in your way. The devil will try you. The devil will see how much you love the Lord. He'll have you just like Peter was for 7 or 8 times in what he did in the Lord's church. Yes, he will. But don't listen to Satan. God is more powerful than Satan. When the Lord was out there on the mount, and it was the 4th chapter of the book of Matthew's, and he had been out there for 40 days and 40 nights. The devil came to him. See, the devil know where your weakness are. The devil know your weakness better than you know where it is. 40 days. The devil told the Lord, "If you be the Son of God, turn these stones into bread." Now, he wanted the Lord to turn the stones to bread. Lord wasn't going to give him any wheat rolls. Lord wasn't going to do anything that satisfies him. He said, "Get behind me, for it is written, you need to serve the Lord and him only." Tell the devil to get behind you. Devil don't like for you to put God on him. Devil began to loosen and run and get out of the way. So that's why we need to study God's word at every opportunity we can. Study to show thyself approved unto God, that you can be a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, that you may rightly divide the word of truth. If you're here tonight, you can come and obey the gospel of Jesus Christ, rededicate your life as we together stand and sing the song of eternity.
Church, I'm just a nobody trying to tell anybody about somebody who can save everybody. I'm just a nobody trying to tell anybody about somebody who can save everybody. Do you want to be saved? Tell anybody about some.